On November the 24th, 2000, a little after 3 o'clock on that autumn afternoon, on the top of the Cross Mountain in Medjugorje, Father Slavko Barbaric died suddenly, at the age of 54.
He finished the Way of the Cross. He climbed it, this mountain, together with his parishioners. And when he finished the Way of the Cross, on the way down, he sat here and his heart stopped. He died. So this rock here was not originally here, but it was brought by Cenacolo boys. They made this plaque even here. They want to show the appreciation for all the work that he did for Cenacolo boys. And of course, pilgrims, us the guides, we all remember Father Slavko, and we are very grateful to him as well for his great work and his great love for all of us and for Our Lady.
Father Slavko was born in 1946 in a small village of Dragicina, near Medjugorje in Bosnia and Herzegovina, to a simple and hard-working Croatian family of 6 children. He attended school in Cerin and high school in Dubrovnik. In 1965, Father Slavko entered the novitiate of the Franciscan province of Herzegovina in Humac. He studied theology and philosophy in Visoko, Sarajevo, and Schwaz in Austria. On December 19th, 1971, in Austria, Father Slavko was ordained a priest. During his lifetime, he worked in many parishes in Herzegovina. However, one parish marked his life in a very special way, the parish of Medjugorje. It was during Father Slavko's studies in Germany that the news about 6 children claiming to see the Mother of God, Our Lady, the Queen of Peace, who was appearing to them in at that time an unknown village in the communist country of Yugoslavia. After having finished his studies, Father Slavko came back home to Herzegovina in 1982 and got involved with Medjugorje in many different aspects. In 1983, he was officially appointed a chaplain to Medjugorje, and he spent most of the following 18 years working and serving in Medjugorje or visiting from the neighboring parishes. During the time of the Homelands War in the 90s, Father Slavko set up the Mother's Village and Orphanage. A beautiful recreational park called St. Francis Garden, right next door to the orphanage. He was inspired to set up a foundation to help talented students. And he also set up another foundation to help children of the deceased defenders who died during the war in the 1990s. Father Slavko was spiritual director to the Cenacolo community. He also set up the House of the Merciful Father. Both of these communities are helping the youth to recover from different forms of addiction. The Risen Lord Prayer Park. Inspired by Father Slavko and the priests of the parish. Unfortunately, Father Slavko never saw it completed because of his untimely death in the year 2000. One of the great gifts that Father Slavko left us with in Medjugorje has been the gift of the Holy Hour. It is like a trinity. We have the inspiration of the music, the inspiration of the spoken word, and most important of all, the inspiration of being present in front of Jesus in the monstrance. And as we kneel with thousands of pilgrims at the outside altar, you get the feeling of unity with the Lord, but also unity with the heavenly host of angels and the communion of saints.
My earliest memories about Father Slavko are connected to the house behind me. We call it Domus Pacis, the House of Peace. So this is our retreat house in Medjugorje that was, of course, built in the time when Father Slavko was here. So he started many, many retreats. And maybe some of you remember also attending his retreats and being accommodated in this house. So anyway, many years ago, when I was young, I started attending those retreats for the youth. The young people. We would spend a couple days here in order to be here for the New Year's Eve. So for the New Year's Eve, we would go all together, of course, with Father Slavko to the Church of St. James. And to me, this was just amazing. Great memory that I can share with you how privileged we were that Father Slavko allowed us, the young people, also Cenacolo boys. Some of you know, those are the boys who had addiction, were the only ones who were allowed to be together with him at the altar. So that evening, we were all sitting around Father Slavko, who was leading the adoration and the Holy Mass. And this was the way we started the new year.
One little thing that I just remembered, and that was the first time I was helping him and Franciscans with a translation for the youth festival. I was a young student and I was translating in Italian, and I found it very, very hard. It's not that I was making mistakes only. In one moment, I simply stopped because they were just going too fast and I was not able to follow them simultaneously. Thank God a colleague of mine was there and she took over, and then everything was fine at the end. And then I was so embarrassed. And later on, when I met Father Slavko in front of the church there on the steps on the left, he greeted me and he said, "Oh, it wasn't great." I said, "It was awful." But he said, "Listen, that's not important. You're just starting. But it's good that you're here with us. Be around. Stay here. Learn. We need you."
On the 25th of November 2000, day after Father Slavko died, Our Lady gave this message. "Dear children, today when heaven is near to you in a special way, I call you to prayer, so that through prayer you'll place God in the first place. Little children, today I'm near you and I bless each of you with my motherly blessing, so that you have the strength and love for all the people you meet in your earthly life, and that you can give God's love. I rejoice with you, and I desire to tell you that your brother Slavko has been born into heaven and intercedes for you. Thank you for having responded to my call."
I first met Father Slavko at a Marian conference in Wichita in 1997. Father Slavko was with Witzka, who was one of the visionaries from Medjugorje, and she was the principal speaker at the conference. I was to give my witness immediately after Witzka's talk and before Father Peter Mary Rookie celebrated the opening mass. And it's a little strange because I felt a little uneasy because I felt I was being sandwiched between Our Lady and between Jesus. A little nervous, but as soon as the music started, I started to relax. I gave my witness, I sang a few songs, and then the hour's presentation finished, and I returned to the speaker's room in readiness for Holy Mass. When the door opened and Father Slavko came running towards me, and he put his arms out to give me a hug, and we embraced, and then he said to me, "How come I've never heard of you before?" And I joked, I said, "Father, you're one of millions." He said, "David," he called me David. "David," he said, "this is the type of music that Medjugorje needs." He said, "Are you coming to Medjugorje?" I said, "Strange you should say that, Father, because Anne and I celebrate our 25th wedding anniversary in June. And we have booked to go." "Oh," he said, "David, please come," he said, "but make sure you bring your music with you." So June came along and Anne and I headed off to Medjugorje. We arrived and the following morning we went to Holy Mass at 10 o'clock. And when we came out of the church, we turned right to go down towards the graveyard where I had my healing. And as we walked past the white dome, Father Slavko was sitting in a chair in the middle of the white dome and he was giving a presentation to some pilgrims. And as soon as he saw me, he jumped up and ran over towards him and said, "Oh, David, welcome to Medjugorje." He said, "Did you bring your music with you?" So I had. And he said, "We will meet tomorrow after Mass," which we did. And he invited me to join with the choir singing at the Adoration at 10 o'clock that night. He asked me specifically to sing during the Adoration. He asked me to sing the Our Father, which he said touched him very deeply at the conference. When I sang that, then he asked me if I would sing a special request for him, that I would sing the Ave Maria in honor of Our Blessed Mother. So I sang from the white dome, total darkness in front of me, and you could see the light on the cross mountain. And as I sang, I could hear my voice and the music echoing off the mountain and coming back down. When we finished, there was a round of applause from those who were there, and Father Slavko came over, helped me to pack up all my equipment, and then we left the white dome. And then he said to me, "David, on Friday, after we have veneration of the cross, would you give your testimony and I will translate it in the Church of St. James?" Which I did. And I must have been one of a very few people who ever gave the testimony in the Church of St. James. But I found Father Slavko to be really very endearing. He was very interested in people. It was like as if we were long-lost friends, that we had been friends all of our life. But I just felt that Christ was in him. I felt that he was the embodiment of what the Lord wants us all to be.
20 years after his death, we Medjugorje guides and all Medjugorje people remember our dear priest, dear Franciscan, Father Slavko Barbaric. He was spiritual guide to Medjugorje guides. And for us, it was an unbelievable experience to have him. Unfortunately, I personally passed the exam, and I think thanks to him, only in 1997. And I worked with him only for 3-4 years. But those years that we guides spent with him were definitely something very precious. However, my earliest memories, I would say, would be me as a kid being in St. James's Church in Medjugorje, and the Mass would be over, and he would stand there on the altar to give announcement. And he would do it in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 languages. Somehow I think that at that time, I started falling in love with languages. For me, it was an inspiration to see a simple Franciscan speaking so many languages so fluently. When we were high school later, I remember that we would go up the Cross Mountain, and I think that already at 6 o'clock, we would start being so proud that we were up so early. But at that time, Father Slavko was already going down, always greeting us, the youth, and reminding us to pick up the litter and not to leave any garbage behind us. And then, somehow now I remembered, I think it was 1998, I started for the first time helping him here with the youth festival and translation. And I remember that we had the meeting underground of the parish house. Father Slavko met with us translators, and I'll never forget what he said. He said, "Youth, I'm counting on you. You do what you can. And this week now, this is the week for you, youth. I spoke to our nuns this morning and I said to them, 'Nuns, I love your music. I love the organs, but please take a week off. We want to bring the youth, let them play the music they wish.'" And that was the first youth festival that I translated.
So in the year 2000, when I was living in France, when I came home this afternoon, it was a Friday afternoon, I saw my fax machine, my telephone blinking from every corner. And I said, "What on earth is going on?" And I saw messages coming from Medjugorje all the time. All the friends, the visionaries had called and said, "Call, call, call, something's happened." Nobody said what happened. And then I punched on the fax, and it said, "1 hour ago, our beloved Father Slavko died on Križevac." I remember the feeling of just when my mind went blank. I had the experience of the most incredible joy, and one I never had before, never had since. It was like a relief that he had made it, that he had arrived, he was safe, and he was over, you know, this feeling of the cross was done, you know, he had arrived. And I was so joyful, I couldn't believe it. And I called my then husband and said, "Look, I need to go to Medjugorje because Slavko died." And so I took my little daughter and we came. It was a really rough journey, actually, and met all the old friends like Bernard Ellis and everybody in the airport in Zagreb, and waited for like 9 hours and arrived here at 3 in the morning because it was Bura and we couldn't fly. And then it was the most extraordinary experience because so many people were here, and people were so, so sad and so shocked. And I had to keep this joy in. And then Our Lady gave this amazing message where she said that she was close, that heaven was close to us like never before in a very special way, and that she was rejoicing with us, and our brother Slavko had been born into heaven, and, you know, and is interceding for us. And she asked us to pray so that through prayer we would have the strength to love every person that God would put on our earthly journey's life. When I saw that message, I thought she had said exactly how Father Slavko was living. And for me, he was always impressive because he was a man who did everything through prayer. And one night I found him, I saw him. I was coming back from the hill and I saw him. I said, "Pasaka, why are you up so late?" And I was, I mean, like typical stupid word, but he said, "I am digesting that the war is coming." And he did it through prayer in the middle of the night. So Father Slavko, for me, in the years that I saw him and I could assist his mission here, was always a man who did everything through prayer. And he was a man who really believed deeply that God was calling people to come here and was giving them the grace of conversion. And he himself always used to say of himself, "I am having no experiences, no mystical things, and I'm nearly jealous of all those who do." But what in truth, what he was living, he was listening to the people and their experiences and the visionaries and the people, his own people, that was giving him what Medjugorje actually was. And he was 100% priest, 100% Franciscan, 100% in that freedom and liberty and simplicity, such a pure heart, no? And so I found the glory of dying on Križevac after a fasting week, 2 days before Christ the King, who was his king, the king of his heart, I would say, taken home. I think it was the biggest, I don't know, like most glorious death I could imagine for this man. And he was ready to leave. He was told to go as far away from here as possible, but he did. There's no ticket back from where he's going to, but he's now here behind the church, and people come to his grave, and there is no more candles on Apparition Hill. They're here, and you know, and it's all the way he put so many things, walking, the evening adoration, so many things, and he left. And he had no position, but he left a trace in people's hearts and in the parish. And today we know that he prays for us, and he's there where we all wait for us. And he's expecting of us to do as he taught us to do.
Father Slavko is buried in Kovacica, one of the local graveyards in Medjugorje. Thousands of people attended his funeral, many coming from overseas, to say their goodbyes and to thank Father Slavko for all he had done for our Blessed Mother and her beloved Son, Jesus. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.